Hello, welcome. Today we're going to go through kind of a real-world example of using the heat pipe calculator, and we're going to try to do somewhat of a complex example here to kind of show some of the preliminary considerations before actually running the heat pipe calculator. So we pulled this image from our website, and it's a embedded heat pipe chassis, so it has fins off the backside and has multiple components in there, and we're going to just basically try to do the heat pipe calculator for one of these heat pipes in the system. So just the first consideration is the total power here. So in this case, you have a 1-inch by 1-inch block that's inputting about 50 watts, and that heat is going to be distributed between two heat pipes that you can see there. So we know the power from our system considerations, then understanding the geometry. So we're just going to put some values here for geometry. We have a 2-inch on the bottom side of the U and 3 inches for each of the vertical sections of the U. So again, the total length here is about 8 inches. And the next stage is to figure out the height against gravity. So this is probably the one that is most complex with this type of geometry. So if this system were sitting flat on a table, the height against gravity would be zero. The heat pipes would be operating horizontal. But if this thing were going into a system where you don't know what the orientation is, you have to design for worst case height against gravity. And that's where you need to figure out the maximum distance in this U that the wick structure, the internal ID of the pipe, would need to pump against gravity, so against the gravity head in your system. And that, in this case, is kind of the diagonal section there. So that's about 3.6 inches. So with that, we have all the inputs. So you have an 8-inch total length, a 1-inch evaporator. Because the fins are distributed across the entire length of the heat pipe, we're going to consider that every area, not the evaporator, is the condenser. So we're going to consider a 7-inch condenser. And just for a single point of operation, we're going to consider 65 degrees CSD operating temperature that we need to move the 25 watts at. And then the desired watts is that the desired heat transport is the 50 watts divided by 2 because you're distributing among two heat pipes. So we have all the inputs, and then we're going to go on to ACT's website, and you can find the calculator in the resources tab. Resources heat pipe calculator, and then again it has kind of a simplified picture there, but we just went through the steps to determine for that specific geometry, and then it's just a matter of plugging those inputs. So we have an 8-inch total heat pipe length, we have a 1-inch evaporator, a 7-inch condenser, and 3.6 inches against gravity. So we can go ahead and submit that, and then it outputs the curves. So this curve is the heat transport at various diameters, and then you go to your operating condition, which is 65 watts, so right about here, and you figure out what the smallest diameter is that can move that heat. So in this case, if we go to a 4-millimeter pipe, you can see it moves about 33 watts, so you have some safety margin in there, and that 4-millimeter heat pipe can move your power there. So that'd be a good optimal size to keep everything thin and move the total power. And then from there, you can submit to ACT if you want to have us view it and give you a call back. And we can also help support the fin optimization or the heat pipe layout to strategically place them in there to optimize performance. But this gives you a good first order approximation of how heat pipe's going to work in your system. So if you have any questions, feel free to give us a call. We'd be happy to run through it in real time or specific to your geometry, but hope this was helpful.